In childhood, most of us would have spent more time in pumping the bicycle tire than riding the bicycle. But have you ever thought how this bicycle pump works without any electrical power? In this video, let's learn how bicycle pump works. Before going into this video, I need a small favor from you friends who are watching this video. Now, as a single man, I am trying to make a high quality animation content for educational purposes. So please support me by subscribing the channel and share it to the maximum number of people. The more you support, the more enthusiastically I can make videos frequently. Once we reach considerable amount of audience, we can hire people to make more high quality animation education contents for our channel. And also, please do watch our previous videos in this channel. Now let's get into the video. This is called pump handle, using which we pump. The next part is piston. It's a very important part of the pump. In this piston, there will be a one-way valve. In this one-way valve, the air can enter only in one direction. The air entering the one-way valve cannot get outside through the same valve. The spring in the pump prevents the piston from airlock and jamming. It's the base of the pump. It helps the pumps to stand in position. It's the hose of the pump. It helps the air from pump to get inside the tire. It has a locking mechanism on the other side. It's the top portion of pump. If you observe it carefully, you can see two small holes through which air from surrounding atmosphere gets into the pump. To understand how bicycle pump works, first we have to understand some basic properties of air. When volume increases, pressure decreases. When volume decreases, pressure increases. Gases always move from high pressure area to low pressure area till it achieves equilibrium. For example, let's consider a small box having air particles inside. Since the volume of the box is very small, the air particles inside the box are having high pressure. As a result, the air particles inside the box are moving so fast. But suddenly when we increase the volume, automatically the pressure gets decreased. As a result, the air particle starts to move slowly. If you want us to make a separate video on this topic, please leave a comment in the comment box. Now let's see an example for the second statement. Let's connect two different boxes together, one with high pressure and another one with low pressure. If you observe this carefully, you can notice that air from high pressure box moves towards low pressure box. This happens till equal pressure is attained on the both boxes. To say simply, it happens till equilibrium is attained. If you have understood these properties clearly, then it will be very easy for you to understand how bicycle pump works. Now let's see how bicycle pump works. The portion below the piston is called compression chamber. It is the place where the air gets compressed. At top portion of the pump, there are two holes through which surrounding air enters into the pump. There are two important valves inside the pump. One is inlet valve and the other is outlet valve. Both of these valves are one-way valves. The speciality of one-way valve is air can only enter into it. Air entering one-way valve cannot exit through the same valve. So it's a single directional valve. These valves are automatically opened and closed based on the movement of piston and pressure difference inside the pump. Now let's observe what happens when you raise the piston up. When we raise the piston up, you can clearly notice that there will be an expansion in the compression chamber. Because of it, pressure decreases in the compression chamber. But above the piston, there will be a high pressure created. As we have seen in the properties before, due to this pressure difference, immediately the air starts flowing from high pressure area to low pressure area to achieve equilibrium. Now I guess it would be easy for you to correlate the properties which we have seen before and the process happening here inside the pump. When we move the piston down, the inlet valve automatically closes due to pressure difference and the piston movement. And it starts compressing the air inside the compression chamber. The compression in compression chamber continues to happen till certain amount of pressure is attained. Once the required pressure is achieved, the outlet valve automatically opens and air starts flowing from the compression chamber to the hose pipe. This flow of air from compression chamber to cycle tire via hose pipe is also because of the pressure difference in compression chamber and cycle tire. Hose pipe and cycle tire will be having less pressure compared to the compression chamber. When we move piston down, we can also notice that above the piston there will be an expansion happening. Due to this expansion, surrounding air particles enter inside the upper portion of the piston. This is how a bicycle pump works, and this process happens in a cyclic loop in order to pump air inside the bicycle pump. I hope now you would have understood how a bicycle pump works. Even now, if you couldn't understand, then watch this 2D representation of a bicycle pump in 0.25x speed, then you will surely understand. In childhood, I used to think and feel amazed at how this bicycle pump works without any electricity. Finally, I got an answer for that question after many years, only when I was making this video. Like this, every one of us would have many questions about different things, like how this stuff works, how these things are happening. If you have any questions like that, then leave a comment in the comment box. Let me try to find research and get an answer to make a high quality animation content for your doubts too. Have you ever wondered why the air inside the bicycle tire doesn't come outside? Let's see that in the next video. Till then, stay curious.